with The Burt Show.
So let me circle back to last week on why I was out on Friday. It was a crazy couple of days, you guys. So I've had this neck problem probably for over a year. And I've just been assuming, people have been telling me, oh, yeah, I have the same neck problem. It's because you're looking down at your phone, looking down on a computer, which is 100% true. So I figured that was it. Well, these nagging, like, neck injuries on both sides of my neck wasn't going away. So I hired somebody to come in with me every week just to stretch it out and to massage it. And over the course of the last year, it's progressively gotten, incrementally gotten a little bit better. There are a couple of great weeks and then it goes back and then it feels better. So I'm sticking with this dude. Well, I get back from vacation and my neck's tighter than usual. So he comes on in and he doesn't even really spend that much time on my neck and shoulders this week. But during his session, there was one position that really like triggered a lot of pain for me. So he stopped immediately and then we just kept going on. Well, as it happens, sometimes when he leaves, I feel 100% great, but there are other times where I feel like I just worked out. And this was one of those days where I just felt like I worked out, just my neck and my shoulders. So when I got up on Thursday morning, I came in to do the show. These guys could see how much pain I was in.
You looked miserable.
It was a really, really bad morning. Like just taking the headphones off and putting them back on. Yeah. I had zero range of motion in my neck at all, but I gutted through it and got out of here as soon as the show was over and tried to rest, right? It just got worse and worse and worse as the day went on. And it got to a point where I couldn't even swallow. If I used the muscles in my neck to swallow, I would wince every single time. So I'm sort of in this traction position all day long. And it's just getting worse and worse and worse. And with every move of my body, my neck is hurting so bad. And I have a pretty high pain tolerance level, honestly. It's probably been the worst pain that I've ever had in my life.
Really?
And I've gone through knee surgeries, LASIK eye surgery. I've gone through it all, man. I've broken a whole bunch. This was the worst.
Even the vasectomy.
Well, that needle is pretty bad.
But, you know, just...
Yeah, needle in the nads. Yeah, that's pretty tough.
Okay.
Right, so I'd take the neck problem, brother.
Yeah. Now, the thing with the vasectomy is that shot is only like 10 seconds long.
And then it's done.
And then it's over, right? Because then it's all numbed up. So it got worse and worse and worse. And then a friend of mine, Mark, got me in to see a doctor. And I went on Friday. And it turns out that I have a pinched nerve in my neck. And I had some degeneration in my spine, which is not a really huge deal, but it can certainly cause problems. So
was the pinched nerve caused by the session?
I don't think so, because it's sort of been the same numb pain. I think he might have released it or moved it in a way that caused it to be in a worse position. But because it's been like this for a year, I don't think he's the one that did it.
Okay.
And I love this guy, too. It's Ernie. It's Bert and Ernie when he comes over.
Oh, man. That's right. I forgot.
Can't break up with Ernie, man.
Yeah, no, you can't do that.
So he's really, really great, and he has... really been very good to me for the last year. But so they shoot shots into my neck on both sides of my neck, and they give me some steroids, a steroid pack today. Damn it, I just forgot. I forgot to take it this morning.
The good news is you still live close, so you can run and get
it. Yeah, I probably will, right? And some muscle relaxers. And my goal was just to feel good enough to get through the Burt Show's anniversary party on Saturday night.
Yeah.
The timing of this was really, really bad because there were people flying in from around the country and we were celebrating 20 years of Burt Show and Kristen was hosting it and it was a really big deal. A lot of people put a lot of work into it and I'm like, I don't know how I got to get there, Doc, but you got to do all the things. Give me 24 hours.
Oh, no, you're
like, it's the finals, baby. Yeah, I got to be ready to go.
Business manager, Amy, would have put you on a gurney and gotten you there in some way, shape, or form.
I had in my head just sitting on a couch and having everybody come up to me like I was the king. Come on up! Because I didn't think I'd be able to move, man. And I just said to the doctors, I'm like, just do whatever you got to do. I got to be ready for Saturday night. If you would have told me I would have felt as good Saturday night as I did, I would have laughed you out of the building. Whatever they did for that 24 hours, and actually still right now, felt great. So I'll take that shot to the neck every time.
Within 24 hours, because watching your Instagram stories.
Impossible.
You looked like you were in so much pain.
Yeah. I figured you was getting hugged all night and somebody, it was hurting you.
One guy.
One guy?
Yep.
Okay.
One guy. The big boss here. Obviously doesn't listen to the show, not on Instagram, was a little excited when he got to the party, hugged me real hard. Real hard. So I think I start physical therapy this week. And for those of you that, I mean, I got so many DMs from people that have chronic pain in their neck and their back and haven't been able to get over it for years. I couldn't even imagine dealing with this pain every single day. Knowing when you go to sleep that you're going to feel like crap the next morning must put you in some kind of depressed state.
It does. Yeah, for so many people who deal with this chronically.
So bad. So I'll let you know how it progresses. But today, I mean, I got this much range of motion.
Not bad. All
right. Much better than Friday, Thursday.
It's about 15%. I can do 15% right here.
The Burt Show.